Hello everyone, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 263. Truecaller, the popular caller ID mobile application for Android and iOS, has launched its fifth annual global spam report. This report gives us an insight into how spam and scam affected 2021 globally. Truecaller has also provided the top 20 countries affected by spam calls in 2021. In the list, India moved from 9th position to 4th position. Let's take a look at all these insights. In 2021, spam calls and SMS remained a global level problem. Truecaller says the reason that spam and scam business still exist is that it is hugely profitable for very little effort and consequences. With over a decade of refining machine learning algorithms, the company is trying to help its 300 million active user base globally to avoid these calls and messages. Samsung could be working on a phone with both foldable and a rollable design. This patent was filed at WIPO, that is World Intellectual Property Organization, back in June this year and was published on December 16. This handset's rollable display rolls in and out whenever required. During the Oppo Inno Day 2021, the company had revealed a number of new technologies it had been working on. This included its first commercial foldable smartphone, the Find N, the Air Glass, and even its first NPU imaging chip as well. Now, a new patent has revealed that the company might be working on a new futuristic device as well as that features an interesting design. Looking at these images, we can see that the smartphone has a quite unique design and could possibly be an upcoming Find X4 series model. Caviar has announced a new iPhone 13 Pro and iPhone 13 Pro Max Stealth models. The Stealth 2.0, iPhone 13 Pro and iPhone 13 Pro Max are strong enough to withstand a gunshot, according to the Caviar. The Caviar's armored iPhone 13 devices starts from $6,370, that is approximately 4.85 lakh rupees. IQ Neo 5 Software Edition design has been officially revealed ahead of its impending launch on December 28. The upcoming handset will feature a triple rear camera setup with a 50-megapixel primary camera. This device could house a MediaTek Dimensity 1200 chipset inside it. Instagram recently began testing a major change to its Stories platform, which lets users post photos and short videos that stay live for 24 hours. Social network wants to increase the maximum length of videos on Stories to 60 seconds in another attempt to beat Snapchat and TikTok. Instagram application is now notifying a few users about this change. Currently, if you record or upload a video longer than 50 seconds, it will automatically be split into multiple different stories. According to the Counterpoint research reports, MediaTek led the system-on-chip shipments. The data indicated a growing gap between the MediaTek and Qualcomm in processor shipments in the third quarter of the year 2021. Unisoc followed the ranking of chip makers ahead of the Samsung. The rise of MediaTek is corresponding to the seemingly steady decline of HiSilicon, which now holds about 2% of the market from the lofty heights. First in the list, we have MediaTek and followed by Qualcomm and Apple. And fourth in the list, we have Unisoc and followed by Samsung and HiSilicon. Foldables are now commonplace in the public eye. They are now more mainstreams than ever before and everyone is itching to get their hands on one. Therefore, it is no surprise that every phone manufacturer is rushing in to launch their first ever foldable, with the Oppo just announcing its Oppo Find N this week. Although the current global foldable market is only dominated by Samsung, the Chinese foldable market tells a different story, and notably two major phone manufacturers on the battlefield. Hawaii and Samsung, with the Hawaii holding 64% of the foldable market in China, more than 50%. Hawaii has even surpassed the peak when it was dominating in the Chinese conventional smartphone market during Easter years. In line with Hawaii's announcement about the Hawaii P50 Pocket at its Hawaii Winter flagship keynote event on December 23, 2021. The Epic Games Store free games giveaway runs from December 16 to January 6. Epic Games Store users can expect at least 9 new and critically acclaimed games in the giveaway. Most games will be available for free for 24 hours only, but one will be up for grabs for a week. The year 2021 marks the 8th anniversary of the establishment of OnePlus. In a short amount of time, the company was managed to leave its market in the market and garner a fan base of loyal customers. OnePlus has mentioned that the brand has hit the target of selling 10 million units, that too ahead of its schedule. OnePlus has been focusing on the flagship killer and then the premium smartphone market, but since the past couple of years, the company has also started targeting the mid-range segment for the smartphones. Vivo product launch is scheduled for December 22nd, where we will see the debuts of the Vivo S12 smartphone and the company's latest smartwatch offering, the Vivo Watch 2. The upcoming wearable was shown in two live shots by Vivo's official Vivo account detailing its design. And we got a confirmation that Watch 2 will employ a secondary core processor to help the extended battery life. And the new teaser confirms that Vivo Watch 2 will be able to last up to 7 days of the smartphone independent usage with the mobile data, calling and sport health tracking activated. And this figure extended to 14 days when paired with a smartphone. Watch 2 brings around OLED display and will come in at least 2 colors with black and silver color options. Sony has announced what it claims is the world's first vertically stacked CMOS image sensor design, which would potentially be a breakthrough in terms of low-light imaging. According to Sony, the breakthrough was achieved by vertically stacking a layer of pixel transistors below a layer of photodiodes, which has benefits in the shape of stronger saturation signals of pixels, wider dynamic range, and improved low-light imaging performance. PUBG New State gets its first content update that brings new vehicle, winter festive theme weapon and many more. The latest PUBG New State update comes with a Survivor Pass Volume 2 that focuses on Bella from the Dream Runner faction. This update was supposed to come out on December 9, 2021, but it was delayed due to an issue with the app review. Krafton is teasing a new BGMI crossover with the Spider-Man No Way Home. Players can expect new cosmetic and game modes from the BGMI Spider-Man No Way Home crossover. Krafton will announce more details about the new BGMI crossover in the coming days. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.